Popups are a nice and easy way to overlay your current page and maybe get some information from your user by using some inputs, or maybe show your user a little bit of information with a loading dialog, or you name it. In this video, we're going to learn how to implement popups in your .NET MAUI application with the .NET MAUI Community Toolkit. If you've been with this channel long enough, and you know you should, so click that subscribe button already, then you might have seen me post already a video about the Xamarin Community Toolkit popups. Now, the Xamarin Community Toolkit already had these same popups. We changed some things here and there, but it had the implementation for popups already there. In fact, it's one of my most popular videos, so it's about time that I redid the video and updated for .NET MAUI and now show you how to implement popups in your .NET MAUI application. So here in Visual Studio 2022, I just created a file new .NET MAUI application. What I did do is already install the .NET MAUI Community Toolkit. So to do that, right-click on your project, do Manage NuGet Packages. Then in the Browse tab, you will go to Community Toolkit. .MAUI, and that will load a couple of packages. You can just have the community toolkit.MAUI package at the time of recording version 1.3.0. If there's a newer one there, please install that and you should be ready to go. It will pop up a little README file with how to initialize the .NET MAUI community toolkit. It's very easy. Just go to your MAUI program, add this little .use MAUI community toolkit line to your generic host builder, and you should be good to go. Now that we have that in place, we can create a new page, and that page we're going to use as a popup. And basically any page that inherits from a popup object can be used as a popup. So it's easy as that. Let's right click again on our project, and I'm going to do add new item. And now I'm just going to choose in the .NET MAUI category a .NET MAUI content page, a XAML page. You can also do a C# page. It works in code if that's what you prefer. You can totally do that. And I'm going to name this the popup page.xaml. That will add a new page, but it will be a content page, and we wanted a popup. So what we need to do here is change this content page to pop up. It's not going to recognize it automatically. So what you want to do here is add a new XML namespace with MCT, MAUI Community Toolkit is, and I think this is in the view, so I'm going to search for MAUI Community Toolkit, and it's not in the core, I think. So I'm not sure why it doesn't recommend me this, the right one in this IntelliSense thing here, but this is it. And now I can say MCT popup, and there we have it. So this doesn't have a title anymore, so make sure that your IntelliSense is very happy. So title can be gone. We don't have that for the popup, but the rest can stay exactly the same. A little pro tip right here, the popup page.xaml, go to the code behind, because you need to change this inheritance here as well. This still says content page. And I think pro tip that you can just remove this one. You don't even need it. You just have to specify that inheritance in one place. I'm just going to do it anyway, but I think you can not do that. So if you want to be safe, do this popup, and you will have to add the right using here again. So I'm just going to use IntelliSense using Community Toolkit MAUI Views, and it will add it here automatically. Also note, at the time of recording, Visual Studio has a little bug. If you add new pages, it's going to be in the namespace MAUI App 1, which doesn't match the rest of our application. So I'm just going to rename this real quick to MAUI Toolkit Popup Sample, because that's the right one. And I think I need to do that in XAML right as well. So if you encounter this, if you can't find your type, then this is likely the bug. I hope this is fixed by the time that you see this, but this might be it. Okay, so now we're ready to go, basically. This is our popup, and you can do anything with the layout right here. So you can just have this vertical stack layout. We're going to add a little other element in here as well. And you can do all these things. But the popup itself also has some nice APIs and properties. So for instance, we also have the can dismissed by tapping outside of popup. It's a mouthful, but it's very handy. So by default, if you have this popup, actually let's just implement showing it first, and I'll tell you all about this little property right here. So what we're going to do, how are we going to show this popup, right? So let's go back to our main page, which is just the default waving.net bot. So I'm going to go to my code behind, and I'm going to replace this code for this counter button with this dot show popup. IntelliSense is going to help us here already. So show popup and show popup async, you can do both. And with this, we can just say new popup page, and we can show this popup. So you can do this from this page, which is really nice. And in fact, if I run this on Windows, then you will see that we get now this pop-up that we've just shown. It has this little label, which is probably stuck to the top. So the layout could be improved and there's other things that you can do here. But at least we know how our pop-up is going to look like and how to show our pop-up. So let's wait for that to happen. While we do, let's go back to actually our pop-up page and let me tell you about the APIs that I was going to tell you about earlier here. Because what we have here is this can be dismissed by tapping outside of pop-up, right? So what we're going to see is whenever the app loads is that we can show the pop-up, but you can tap outside of it. There is space outside of it, right? Depending on the size that you set, like the width and height, you can set that. If it spans like the whole page, you can't really tap on the edges. But if you can, then it's going to be dismissed. It's going to be gone. But maybe you want to have this modal pop-up, right? So let's focus on the app here first. Click me. We see this pop-up. It's gray with the little label that we have here. And whenever I tap on it, it's fine. But whenever I tap outside of it, it's going to be gone. Maybe you want to have this modal pop-up that's going to show a loading indicator or that's going to show some required information from your user. So let's do this and let's set that property can be dismissed by tapping outside of pop-up to false. So you can see by default it's true, but you can also set it to false. It also has a couple of events, right? I think it has closed and opened so that you can detect whenever the pop-up is opened and closed, and it has a couple of other things. But now we can dismiss it by tapping outside. So what we want to do is maybe also add this little button, right, to actually close the pop-up right now. And we're going to say text is close and a clicked event handler. Let's hook that up and then close this little button tag right here. So there's that. Maybe we want to give this vertical stack layout a background color of, I don't know, what's a nice color? Let's just make it white. And there we have it, right? So we have this thing in place. And now in my pop-up code behind, I can say close. I think this is a method on the pop-up. So we have close. And we can actually provide a object as a result in here. So you can also pass data back and forth between your pop-ups. If anything, this is just the overview and getting started. If you see anything that you would like to know more about, please let me know down in the comments below. And I'll be sure to follow up on that. So here we can just say close, and this is going to close the pop-up because we can't tap outside of it anymore. So now we have that, and I think we have all the things in place. So let's run this again. And what we should see now is this pop-up with a label, but now also a button. And we can't close it by tapping outside of it, but we can close it by putting that button, by tapping that button in there. So that is basically how you can get started with pop-ups. And what is really cool is that you can create all these amazing, crazy layouts. Actually, there's one more thing that I want to show you, which has to do about the sizing, because right now, if you don't specify a size, it's just going to be, you know, it's going to make itself like size according to the controls that are in there, I think. So let's see, here we have the pop-up. Still, the styling is meh. I'm not a designer. You should know that by now. We can click outside of it. Nothing happens, right? But whenever I close the button, it's now going to close. So that's now how this works. I also deployed this to Android just to show you that it, of course, it's .NET MAUI, so it works on other platforms as well. So here we have the exact same app running on Android, and I can do this, click here. I can also click outside. It doesn't do anything, and I can close here, and it will close. Also, a question that I got asked since Xamarin Forms times, here you can see that it dims a little bit, and this is just the way that the platform kind of like shows pop-ups. Right, this is how pop-ups would be implemented in this platform. So here the page dims a little bit. On iOS, that doesn't really happen. I think iOS is more close to Windows. Right here we have this little shadow around the pop-up. As far as I know, there's not really a way to influence that right now, but I should definitely double check. So let me know in the comments if that's something that you're interested in. Maybe open an issue on the .NET MAUI Community Toolkit repo so that we can look into it. So, okay, also working on Android, that is amazing. Now, the thing about size, so you can also specify a size on the pop-up. So we can say size is, and then you can specify, I don't know, 1,000 times 500. Let's do something crazy. You should, of course, make sure that, you know, this is something that is actually available inside of your viewport. And also, you can set this dynamically inside of your code, right? So you could check like the device resolution, make it like half the size of that so that it's always nice and centered. I don't know, stuff like that. You can do all kinds of crazy things here. I'm just showing you that you can also set the size with this to give you a little bit of a basic example of how to work with these pop-ups. Here the application is coming up again, and you will see that the size is now way bigger than it was before, so you can do all these crazy kinds of things here. So that's how you can get started with pop-ups in .NET MAUI applications. There is all kinds of other things to explore here. You can anchor a pop-up to a certain point or element. You can maybe do something with transparent pop-ups. You can, I don't know, the sky's the limit, right? So these pop-ups are really, really amazing. As I already said, let me know down in the comments below if there is something that you want me to explore with these pop-ups or something else in the .NET MAUI Community Toolkit. If you've liked this video, please click that like button so it will spread to more people in the amazing .NET MAUI community, and more people will benefit from that. Thank you so much. Please subscribe to my channel if you haven't done so already. And maybe if you want to know more about the .NET MAUI Community Toolkit, check out this playlist right here. Check out this special video. It's recommended just for your taste. And check out this button to see if you're actually subscribed. See you for the next one.